Hey people, hey. I'm coming to you today. It is Thursday, the 11th of May, and I'm coming because I just came back from Publix to get me and my daughter a sub. And you know, Publix subs are really, really good, and they are cheap. Today I got a turkey sub for $4.99 today, a foot long for $4.99. So, you know, I'm all about the specials, like I said, but today I want to talk to you about baking soda and water, drinking it in your water. I have my little spoon, it's a plastic spoon, and I have my baking soda, which is bicarbonate. How do you pronounce it? Sodium bicarbonate, okay? And that's really good. It helps draw out all those toxins that's in your body. And it also, if you're on a parasite cleanse, you can use that as well to dry out the parasites too that's in your intestines and help get rid of any kind of fungal infection that's inside your intestines. So I have me a water bottle. This is a 16 ounce water bottle, and all I do is, like, every so often, I don't do this every day. I haven't had baking soda in a while, but I used to do it a few weeks ago, and I stopped because I ran out. But I don't put a lot of the baking, I'm gonna be messy right now, but I don't put a lot on the teaspoon, like, see, just smaller than this spoon right here. So I guess that's like half a teaspoon. And I just put it in my water. But you may say that's a lot, too much to be putting in a 16 ounce bottle of water. No, I'm just putting this in right here, just to help this go down. And then I'm gonna be drinking a lot of water for the rest of the day. So that's what you do. You put it in a 16 ounce bottle of water, drink down that bottle of water so it can get in there and start flushing inside, getting, you know, osmosis, getting inside your veins and arteries or whatever it needs to go, tissue, wherever. Trust me, it'll probably search out that fungus and or tumor and start trying to get into that and drying it out. So I'm not a doctor, I don't claim to be a doctor, but I have done research and I've read a lot of articles, I've listened to a lot of people doing their videos and who have experimented with it all as well and researched it as well. And I've always heard good news about baking soda and water. So bicarbonate is what they use in, sodium bicarbonate is what they use in boron. Borax. And all borax is what in the ingredient? Sodium, tetra, I can't really see right now that well. Tetra bicarbonate, I guess. And it's a natural mineral that comes naturally on the earth, you know, that's formed on the earth. So it's natural. And you can even use this in a 16 ounce bottle of water. But you gotta be careful with this. You only use about that much, just like put like a little bit. I'm not good with measuring right now. I'm trying to be a scientist or anything, but you just put a little bit of that on there, just a dab. You can even just dab your finger and then flick it into the 16 bottle ounce of water. But make sure you're drinking lots of water with this boron, because you will get a headache if you take too much of it, okay? So just be careful. People use borax to wash their clothes. That's what it is. It's a laundry detergent. But you can also detox with boron, borax, because borax has boron in it. And boron is a supplement or a mineral that we need in our body that we don't get a lot of, and our plants don't get a lot of. I read that too. You can do the research on it for yourself, but our plants, when they're in their soil, when they're harvesting different plants and fruits and vegetables, our plants and vegetables are not getting enough boron in it, and that's why we're lacking boron in our body. So you can even take the boron pills or their little supplement pills, which if you feel like that's safer for you and you don't want to go this route, that's fine. But I've tried this before. I didn't stay on it a long time because it, like I said, it gives you headaches and you don't want that, and I already have a problem with headaches and stuff like that. But that's if you're using too much. You can do borax for, like, say for instance, just did it for 3 days on and then don't do it anymore for another week and then do it 3 days again. But you're flushing yourself with a lot of water after that. Always do that. Even when you're doing baking soda. So when you're trying to detox your body from suspectful organisms, toxins, parasites, fungus, chemtrails, you know, anything that your body has in it and you're trying to clean it out, you need to do that. And this is a good way. Like I said, 16-ounce bottle of water, like a half a teaspoon of baking soda. Do that. You can do that for like 3 days on and then 3 days off. 3 days on, 3 days off. But you can do the research. Research it, and when you research it, you'll find out what's best for you. And always take it slow. You do it 3 days on and then see how it's working for you every day. Some people are doing this to the point where they're doing it twice a day in water, but they're always flushing with drinking water behind that all day. You know, so it's up to you, but you will see a difference. And you can take a bath with this. You can like pour a cup of this in your bath water and soak in it. And that will help your skin, relieve your skin of any irritants, irritations, you know, stuff like that. And so you can do this, the same thing with borax. You can put a cup in your water, hot water, soak in it for 30 minutes. Or you can use, some people are using borax and, what do they call that? Epsom salt together and soaking in it for 30 minutes. But I wouldn't do that every day. That's my personal opinion. I know my skin has been through a lot and it's very sensitive. So if you have sensitive skin, I wouldn't suggest you do it every day unless you're really on some strong protocol to get rid of these toxins that's in your body. And like I said, I did a video with a reference from a guy named Charlie who has this protocol that can help you with your chemtrail infestation. Parasites, skin fungus, all of that, toxins build up, because he's saying that we are attracting all these organisms, fungus, parasites, chemtrails, EMFs, electronic stimulation or torture, because we are the antennas, because of all this stuff that these chemtrails is putting on us is building a film over our skin. And the only way we're gonna get rid of this film and not be targeted anymore and followed and tracked and overstimulated by electronics. You can't even sit at your desk because the computer is making you be attracted to all the dust that's in the air and pollen that's in the air and making people sneeze around you and stuff like that. So stay focus, research, never give up, have a positive attitude, ignore the haters, ignore the people who don't believe in targeted individuals, who don't believe in microchips, who don't believe in antennas, electromagnetic harassment, gang stalking, community stalking, who don't believe that parasites are man-made and they're being sprayed on us and on our foods, out in the fields and stuff like that. So please, 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 always try to detox. And also, apple cider vinegar. And this is the mother by Brash. You always want to get apple cider vinegar. That's the mother. It's natural. Don't mess with anything that's not natural, because